Welcome to the Wasteland News Network. Today is October 15th, 2021, and a new Inside the Vault was just released. A reminder, we're in the middle of Caps O'Plenty weekend, so feel free to cash in double the amount of caps at all vendors. Our next update for Fallout 76 is set to arrive on Tuesday, October 19th, and with it, Halloween will descend upon Appalachia like costume dwellers on a bowl full of candy. Yay! Quite literally, hungry trick-or-treaters will haunt your doorstep in search of some sweets and challenge rewards. Even the scorched that prowl the wasteland will be dressing in their most hair-raising attire and dropping special treats. Grab your favorite costume and read on to catch all the details that you can join in the fun before these spine-tingling events expire on November 2nd. So we have around 2 weeks of this spooky scorched event. And though the scorched have lost much of what must have made them human, it seems they've managed to retain some semblance of fondness for certain holidays. In fact, as Halloween approaches, they're wriggling into creepy costumes and have begun collecting sweet treats they've stumbled upon. So again, from October 19th, that's Tuesday, through November 2nd, you'll run into these spooky scorched during your adventures in Appalachia. Each one will spawn as legendary, and taking them down will net you a legendary item and a piece of mystery candy. You'll also receive a spooky treat bag, which you can open to receive rewards like consumables, ammo, and even a chance at some Halloween-themed loot. And this is what the spooky treat bag will look like. Now, these will not be available for purchase at any vendors. The event is similar to the Treasure Hunter Mole Miner event, but you can't buy things like you could buy the Christmas presents and you could buy the Mole Miner pails. You will not be able to buy spooky treat bags at all. You will be able to buy the mystery candy, and they will grant you one of 5 random special buffs, like Super Strength, Sugar Vision, Sugar Rush, Lucky Break, and a Mystery Treat Surprise. Now, each of the buffs will last only 10 minutes. And you can also start the event off by claiming a free spooky candy bowl from the Atomic Shop, place it in your camp, and fill it with this mystery candy, whether you've collected it from Spooky Scorched or purchased from vendors. So until November 2nd, all dwellers will receive daily challenges to trick or treat at other people's camp, as well as daily and weekly challenges to hand out treats from their candy bowls. Now, each of these daily rewards that you complete will grant you one of several possible rewards like consumables, perk pack cards, lunchboxes, repair kits, and score. Additionally, weekly challenges to give candy to trick-or-treaters can award you score, rare crafting materials, or even Halloween costumes. And if you complete both weekly challenges, you'll receive the new popcorn machine, which you can build in your camp. Remember to transform your home into a horrifying haunted house that will give your visitors a scare, and be sure to place your spooky candy bowl where others can find it. Don't worry about folks snatching all of your sweet treats in one go. Each dweller will be limited to one piece of candy from your bowl per hour. Finally, just like in real life, you need to be in costume in order to trick or treat successfully, so feel free to dress up. And as part of Bomb Drop Week until October 26th, you can save on both the game itself, Fallout 76, and also there are special Atom Pack bundles at large discounts from October 19th through October 25th. At the bottom of the page, you can see the reductions in price. And next weekend, from October 21 through 25th, I'll send a reminder out. There is a triple threat of weekend events in store. The bomb drop savings continue, and also a scrip surplus event where you can cash in twice the normal daily legendary scrip during the 21st through 25th. And you can also do daily ops. There will be double mutations and also double XP during the daily op runs, as well as twice the currency and legendary core rewards. And that wraps it up. I'm going to give you a quick preview here. This video was shot during QuakeCon, and it gives you a little bit of a look at the Halloween Scorched event. and it will share the same rewards as the original event 2 years ago. So you're going to get those rare costumes like the pirate costume, the jack-o'-lantern suits, the pumpkins, the fireman's helmet, and the fireman's outfit. So here's a quick look at the event.
There's some new and returning events for players to take part in, from Spooky Scorch to Treasure Hunter. We have trick-or-treating coming. Do you guys have a favorite event?
Well, I am super excited about the Spooky Scorched trick-or-treating event. Obviously, the Spooky Scorched are going to be wearing a lot of fun costumes. A lot of them you've seen before, but there might be some new ones. On top of that, though, it's not just going around and killing a bunch of Scorched in costumes. It's more about collecting a certain type of candy, and we're gonna allow players to go to other player camps and effectively trick or treat from a special object in the camp. So I'm excited about this. We're gonna really incentivize players to wanna dress up in their own costumes as well. So it's a really different kind of event than we've done before, because we're trying to incorporate player camps into the event, and hopefully players will decorate their camps and give them a spooky theme along with it.
And that is everything for this week's Inside the Vault. I'll see you guys out in the wasteland.